Are you wondering how you should approach security in the cloud? That is the topic of today's video. Hey everyone, this is Ned Bellavance, and today I wanted to share a video that I recorded last year for an actual tech media event. This is the first in a series that I'm going to call Cloud Perspectives. The topic of the video is security in the cloud. That's something that is like probably on the top of your mind at the beginning of 2023 with, you know, everything that's been happening with Rackspace and LastPass and CircleCI. So the goal is to give you a basic framework for thinking about how you should approach security in the cloud and how it's a little bit different than how you might have done it in your data center in the past. Now, as I said, this video was created for an actual tech megacast last year, and I actually have a whole bunch of these videos that I've produced for their events. The content of most of the videos I would consider evergreen, so I thought it would be nice to share it with an audience beyond those who are just attending the webcast. So I wanted to give you that context because you might hear me mention the event or vendors who were part of it, so I didn't want there to be any confusion about where the next portion of the video came from. With that being said, enjoy the video and I'll see you at the outro. Hey everybody, welcome to today's event. I'm Ned Bellavance and today I'm going to talk to you about rethinking your cloud security. To do that, I'm going to focus on three main points here. The first one is that cloud is not your data center. I know it's tempting to treat it like it's a traditional data center, but guess what? It really, really is not. The second big thing is that identity in the cloud, and well, everywhere, but specifically in the cloud, identity is everything. And then finally, keep it simple, silly. You don't have to over-complexify. Ooh, is that even a word? You don't have to make things overly complex in your cloud security approach. You want to keep it simple and keep that attack surface minimal. So let's focus on the first of those three, which is cloud. It's not your data center. As you begin your journey to the public cloud, there's a temptation there to treat the cloud like just another data center, especially if you're starting to adapt IaaS or infrastructure as a service. After all, when you go to the cloud provider's portal, you see familiar things like virtual machines and virtual networks and subnets. So why not just rebuild exactly what you have in your data center today up in the cloud? Now, the most important thing to understand is what you see in that portal is an illusion. Everything in the cloud is software defined and controlled through an API. So although you're being presented with a subnet or a virtual network, the reality of what's going on behind the scenes is, well, it's dramatically different. Now, the next thing to bear in mind is when you think about your traditional data center, you have things like a perimeter network. You can actually see where the cables are coming into your building and going into your gear. And that gives you a sense for a well-defined perimeter that you can try to defend from a networking perspective. You have things like a stack of centralized firewalls that sit between all of your internal networks and the external network that's outside. You also have something like Active Directory that's providing identity services for all of your internal services. So you might be tempted to shift all that up to the public cloud and create the exact same template up there. Maybe creating a centralized firewall from a virtualized appliance, or bringing your Active Directory up and running domain controllers in the cloud. Can you do all of that? Sure you can. But is it the best way to approach security? I would argue no, and that's because cloud is fundamentally different. Let's take a closer look at why I say that. Probably the most important thing to understand about the cloud is the network that you see is largely, it's an illusion. Any virtual instance that you have running in your public cloud is one API call away from having a public IP address. What does that mean? It means that building a strong perimeter and centralize everything to go through one pair of firewalls is probably not the best design decision that you can make. Instead, you have to take a more distributed approach to your networking and to your security. Things should be enforced at the host level or at the virtual machine level, and you should, restrict communication by service or perhaps by identity, we'll get to that later, instead of doing it by IP address or by subnet. Another important thing to consider is that you're going to be using some level of platform as a service, and that doesn't really adhere to what you have in your data center. The platform as a service components, maybe you can hook them into the virtual networks, but oftentimes you can't. And that means you have to take a slightly different security approach for those because you can't force those through a firewall or some sort of inspection engine. Okay, so those are some of the reasons why cloud is not going to be the same as your data center and you shouldn't treat it as such. The answer is that instead you should use identity for your security. When you're thinking about cloud security, identity is going to be everything. And why do I say that? Well, it's because of how pervasive identity is in all of the cloud providers. Every user account is an identity. Every computer that gets created, every virtual machine, I should say, that also has an identity. Every service that's created has an identity. So when you're constructing things like security groups, or when you're figuring out permissions for authorization, everything is going to be tied back to an identity, and that identity follows a chain of trust. When you think about the users, they are going to be using two-factor authentication, at least they really, really should be, and that allows them to create a trust where you trust their identity to allow them to do things. When it comes to things like service and machine accounts, those are built from the ground up on the cloud provider itself. So there's a chain of trust there, knowing that it's spun up on a specific host and it has all the proper certificates and authorization that you need to be able to trust it. The next big thing is almost everything in the cloud uses short-lived tokens for access. Instead of using a username and password to gain access to every system, it goes back to a centralized authority, whether that's AWS IAM or Azure Active Directory, and gets a token. That token has a minimal lifetime, and you can use that to do things. If that token somehow gets compromised, I mean, they can do a little bit of damage, but that token will expire or can be revoked. So really, embracing the idea of short-lived tokens and identity is going to make your security posture that much better. The next best thing you can do is to keep things simple and avoid unnecessary complexity. The thing about complex systems is, well, they're complex. There's a lot of moving parts. And the more complexity you add to a system, the better the chances that someone's going to misconfigure something. And that misconfiguration opens up an attack vector for someone from the outside to get into your systems. So the simpler and sleeker you can make your security approach and your security controls, the less chance that someone's going to misconfigure something or a vulnerability is going to arise in some piece of software you don't even need to be running, that will allow an attacker to get in, land, and expand. So keeping it simple is going to be huge. Now, how do you keep it simple? How do you push back on folks that are trying to get you to add all these additional controls? Well, my buddy Adil Ahmad has two important questions that he always asks. Why? And so what? So the why is, why are we adding this control? What is it doing? What security is it adding that I don't already have a control for? There's an idea of defense in depth in security, which is multiple controls that are protecting against the same thing. While that seems like it might be a good idea, it's actually adding additional complexity without any real benefit. If you misconfigure one of those controls, you might be allowing an attacker in. So instead, when someone comes with a new control, the first question to ask is, why don't we already have a compensating control for that? Why do I want to add this complexity? The next question to ask is, so what? So what if someone's able to do this one small thing? If they're able to get onto one system but not land and expand because that system is restricted in what it can talk to in the rest of the environment, then it doesn't necessarily matter. You don't have to add this additional control because if an attacker gets in, they can't do anything. And that's really important to bear in mind if you're trying to embrace the idea of simplicity in your security. Okay, those are my big three ideas when it comes to rethinking your cloud security. Let's review them, shall we? The first one is cloud. It's not the same as your data center. You have to take a fundamentally different approach when you're moving to the cloud. And some of the tools and software and applications you're using for security today, they might not cut it when it comes to the cloud. So you might want to pay attention to some of the presentations later and see if something is going to work for you in your cloud journey. The second one is identity is everything when it comes to the cloud. Everything in each cloud provider has an identity associated with it, and you can use that identity to create really robust security policies. The last thing is to keep it simple. You don't want to add additional layers of complexity and security controls for potentially no real benefit and just expanding your attack profile that someone might try to take advantage of. So ask the important questions: why and so what, and use that to keep your security as simple as possible. That's going to do it for me for today. Thank you so much for watching. Again, my name is Ned Bellavance. If you want to reach out, you can find me on Twitter. It's Ned1313, or find me on my website at nedinthecloud.com. Please enjoy the rest of the event. Thanks for that excellent video, Past Ned. And hey, thanks so much to you for watching. Subscribe if you like, hit the bell as well, pell-mell if you're feeling swell. Say that 5 times fast. You can catch another video here-ish, or you can check out my podcast called Chaos Lever, where Chris Hayner and I flesh out topics just like this in more detail, and I'll put a link if YouTube lets me somewhere around here, let's say. Until next time, stay healthy, stay safe out there. Bye for now.